Hello and welcome to Complete Bricks episode 6. It's been a little while since we've been around talking Lego, but we cover just all the kind of general stuff that's been happening the last few weeks on Lego. We're going to share this with you. Co-hosts are here yet again, good friends of mine. We have Tulsa Scott. Good evening, sir.
Hello, how are you?
Very well indeed. Is it getting cold
Fantastic.
in Tulsa for you? It was freezing as hell.
It'll be 30 tonight, so
Oh my
be all
God.
right then.
That's cool. Even in Fahrenheit, that's it's. I still think it's gonna be warm when it says 35F, but never mind. How are you doing, Matt, in San Francisco?
It's probably in the 40s right now, but it's nowhere near as cold as you guys got it, so.
It's 5 degrees. That makes all the difference. Never mind. Okay, so we're talking Lego. We've got some Star Wars. We've got some Ghostbusters. In fact, we've got plenty of Star Wars. We've got a few other bits and pieces. We've got books. We've got customs. We've got Flego. We're going to take you through and share this stuff again. If you're watching this and you see something you like, if you click below the YouTube video, there's all the show notes, and that'll tell you everything that we covered tonight. There's been a few new sets, though, first of all, that have came out recently. Let's take a look at some of them, and a good place for that is Brickset. They've pulled together a list of some of the recent sets, and here's some of them. So there's a few buried down here on the page. I'm just going to scroll down. There's a lot of different licenses, but this leaked out, and there's still no pictures of it. This caught my eye immediately because I'm a complete Iron Man sleazebag. But we're getting a new Iron Man set, and I did not know about this before, but it's a junior set. So Iron Man versus Loki is one that's going to come. We've had a few of these before, but with Batman and stuff. But yeah, there's a few little sets leaked out here. We'll get some other kids stuff, kind of Ariel there from Disney's bits and pieces. If you're into Duplo, there's some Duplo. That takes me back, that stuff, when I was a kid. What else did we have down here? There's a few other bits and pieces, a lot of sets with no images. The only one I've really seen a lot of images for is Star Wars recently. I don't know about you guys, if you've seen anything new out there other than the Star Wars stuff, but
There's been some more high-res images of the Marvel sets that are coming, like the
oh, is
Captain
there?
America subset and the Loki set has actually the image for that surface as well.
Oh, okay.
Just better images over time.
Yeah.
But and even some of the box art for those. But the biggest things as of yet are pretty much Star Wars sets. They've just been kind of flooding out.
Exactly. Well, there's been a few bits and pieces here. We'll talk about some of this stuff here as well. This Star Wars set and bits too. But it's a good guide if you're looking for stuff and you hadn't found out about it yet. The Brickset guys tend to kind of scrape a lot of the Lego servers where some of the manuals are, and they find images and they put them up there. But there's a good pile of stuff that's coming. But the biggest, as we said, was Star Wars, and we managed to get some high-res images. This all came from a German retailer. It's always like some e-tailer that manages to leak all this stuff. But yeah, this wasn't asked to be taken down, so we got a little look at some of these new sets. We'll plow through them. Did any of you guys buy the bigger version of this, the non-microfighter one?
No.
Yes.
Did
You
you?
did.
Ah,
You
okay.
did. Wow.
It's now I got it when it was, $60-something dollars at Walmart when they had marked them down. It is in the box of treasures. It has not been assembled by any means,
The
but
college fund piece.
yeah, it's not for resale. It's
The
for building later. But we did pick that up. I am the only one who knows about it, but it is in the box.
He knows about it
Non-micro.
now.
Yeah, I know.
But
But we did pick up the big Ghost after watching some reviews and some of the builds and everything on it. It seemed like a really cool larger set to have, and when it went a bit cheaper than that, $89 price point, we went ahead and we picked it up because we weren't sure if some of these other figures would see the light of day in any way, shape, or form. So
So do you manage to get the Phantom as well to go with it?
we have the Phantom. The Phantom has been built and
Nice.
disassembled and is in pieces everywhere, but we do have the Phantom. We do have the Phantom in-house. So,
It took a crash landing.
oh, it got kind of pulled apart and rebuilt and stuck sideways, and now there's kind of white and orange bricks kind of everywhere. But
Speaking of the Ghost, actually, I need to post it, but I just spotted at Toys R Us. They're now carrying the Phantom Ghost 2-pack. They just started carrying it, and I think that was only available through Shop at Home at LEGO. Mm-hmm. But now they're carrying. I don't know what the price is, but I saw three of them the last time I went to Toys R Us. So
that's like a giant two-in-one sets, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, most of the time those are available only through LEGO, but Toys R Us has such a good deal with LEGO in general that they wind up getting like last year's giveaways and promos mm-hmm. and things like that. Like they seem to get a lot of stuff that other retailers aren't getting their hands on. So
what's that worked out to, about $109 or $119 for a price point between?
I didn't get a price on it, but yeah, it would probably be somewhere around there.
That's right. I remember seeing that for that price point at one point. Well, look, this one's gonna be popular. I think this is a cool looking little set. We're kind of fans of lower price sets in some way. These little things, I think we've talked about before, but
what do they usually put out? What, eight microfighters in a series? Is that what it is?
Six, I think it is normally.
Is it only six?
It's only six.
Seems like one of them.
It could be eight this time, but
so we've got what, the Ghost, the Wookiee fighter.
That's right, the Wookiee fighter with I think it's an existing. This isn't a micro fighter, but this is one of the sets. Now we talked about this before, but it's a closer look at it. Just right. The box art. This is one of the Battlefront sets. This is the Rebel. Mm-hmm. Great to get that Duros guy and the little jetpack going on there.
Yeah.
This was one I'm sure that'd be popular in some ways, but you've almost already had this.
Yeah,
ship
this seems almost like a rehash.
Yeah.
It's just the Rebels versus the pilot.
Yep.
Yeah.
The one cool thing about that Ghost is I'm glad, and we had actually talked about this before, is that they're finally including figures that are not just soldiers or builder type packs. You're actually getting a real character like Hera. So.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good point. But we've had a few type pilots, but there was a polybag not all that long ago that I'm sure we were all talking about on Twitter or something, which just came out. So it's like, it's kind of invasion of the ties. We're just kind of getting tons of these things.
That's just a rebuild of the Interceptor with the different wings?
That's true, actually.
Because have they done a regular tie? I don't think they've done a regular tie.
I don't think they've done a regular tie, no. No, I don't think they have. So... Oh, they get plenty of ships to do, man, that's for sure. There's a closer look at...
So if there's six, we get the Ghost, the Wookiee gunship...
There's a Snow Speeder. I've got a photo somewhere on my desktop. It's not actually live, but we've got a photo of the Snow Speeder that's coming. But there is... Love this guy.
Oh, there's the ATDP. Okay. Yeah.
That was always one that was kind of hard to get because of the set. The price point, again, was a little bit more expensive. Mm-hmm. This is the Wookiee gunship again. That's another non-microfighter set, but that kind of attaches onto the previous sets we've had before. Do like that one. And we were right about these little bases. They do seem to be... I've seen tons of photographs now with these bases.
It's been sort of an interesting conversation because a lot of people actually have been bringing up those little round disc bases, and it seems like those will actually be in the sets as stands, so...
I know, it's bizarre.
It's interesting. I thought they were just part of the promo pictures. But.
Yep, no, you're getting stands in this weird kind of gray format there.
So. But it's not in all of them, though, because that next picture you had,
yeah, that's true.
Were not, none of those figures are on stands.
Well, this is a battle pack. This is a smaller set here. So not in microfighters, it seems in larger sets only. So, again, don't know the difference here, but. This is going to be popular, the Shock Trooper, because his 6-inch version has been going crazy in Walmart, that's for sure, selling that through, but that looks good. There's another close-up of this guy. He's awesome, too, like that. It feels like we've had tons of these little walkers in different shapes and sizes, though. There's the TIE Advanced Prototype, I should say. There's that little set there again for that Shock Trooper. Another picture of that. And there's the Kanan set, Kanan speeder bike set. And again, I'll get that Snow Speeder set in just one sec. I'll see if I can find that where we're talking. But yeah, there are other ones coming there. I don't have a full list.
There's a couple Force Awakens that they all showed as well. There's going to be a blue X-Wing and a Snow Speeder, which is now First Order or not.
In Microfighter? In Microfighter size? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's two coming.
I would have liked to see a like a mini A-wing, just because they've been using the A-wings in Rebels. or a mini Taintiv styled ship, just because they've been using that heavily this season. So, with just some little Commander Sato or Captain Sato or whatever it was.
And it's kind of a we've had a Snowspeeder before, so this is just a kind of again another updated version of it for the next Microfighters sequence. We'll get something. We'll put something in the show notes there. But there's plenty of these Microfighter sets coming. That is for sure. Switching off from Star Wars just for a minute onto something that was pretty big announcement, I think, for LEGO. They spent a lot of time on this set, a lot of promotion PR on the set was the LEGO Ghostbusters Firehouse.
Yeah.
This looks amazing. We'll share this in just 1 second here. But around $400, you're getting a mammoth set. But let's take a look at this. And see what you guys think of this, but the you visited the place in New York where the original set was launched, or the actual set is, I should say, where they filmed the movie, and they took props and set this up outside. So there you go. There's the actual place that filmed the movie, and of course we're getting the Ghostbusters next movie next year, so we're getting the all female version. But this just looks like one of the finest sets I have ever seen for LEGO producing. Very much like a kind of LEGO Death Star in some ways, just for intricacy and detail and minifigures. So let me blast this up a little and we'll go through these and look at them. But we've had Ghostbusters before. I don't know if you guys bought the Ecto-1.
I did.
Great set. Absolutely fantastic. Yeah. That one is really holding its value. It has not shifted down in price whatsoever. So it's only going to go up, I think. But
I mean, Toys R Us has been. There's only one Toys R Us around me that still carries it, and I just see that set being just like the Back to the Future set.
Yeah.
The Uso Back to the Future. It's going to be the same thing because that thing retailed, I think, around 30, and you can't get any less than 100 now.
That's crazy. Oh my God. Well, there you go. Grab the Ecto-1 before Christmas because. I saw just someone had posted tonight the annual kind of LEGO clearance is happening in stores. It's just always the same. It's always hard to get LEGO until the beginning of January. So if you're desperate, grab it. But I love the little LEGO Ghostbusters, or the Ghostbusters logo on him there, on Peter Venkman. And they're all got little slime variations. That's Stance, Raymond Stance. And Egon Spengler. I love the little Elvis hairpiece there. Looks fantastic. There's Winston Zedmore. And that looks fantastic. She's smoking.
Yeah.
I think that's a brand new hair sculpt as well. I've never seen
that. Look at that leg print, too.
That's
a great leg print.
Check out that leg.
No, it really flows with the top half of the figure. That's a good print.
You always seem to pick good show titles, Scott. So I think that's it. We've got leg print.
Look at that leg print.
gives good leg print, but she's beautiful. I mean, she's beautiful in the film, but it's really nice. So that's quite a unique and stunning looking little minifigure. And even I've completely forgotten his name, but what was his name in Ghostbusters?
It was a Rick Moranis.
Rick Moranis. Yes, his character. Yeah. I can't remember. But that looks really good as well, using the kind of younger style hair piece as well there. No print on the legs, but it looks good. The
Annie Potts.
Annie Potts, thank you. That's what I was going to say. Yes, the secretary at the Ghostbusters Firehouse. But I love that, the glasses, the print that they've got on there.
It's that's perfect.
Zombie taxi driver. That could almost double for the taxi driver in Scrooge, I think, if you know what I mean. I don't know who this is. I think this is just a made-up character, I think,
couple of ghosts for the set, maybe.
Exactly. So it's a brand new, unique-looking piece, as is this pink one. And Slimer, which is looking fantastic. Now, we are getting a Slimer in the Dimensions packs, I think, in early February, so this looks slightly different, the print. That's the ghost from the library. I love this piece that's been used on a lot of the ghost minifigures that we've had out. That's a really cool way of doing ghost kind of lore torches. That's a really nice thing.
Yeah, they use that piece a lot in Ninjago. Cause I wasn't that aware of that piece, and when they first showed that sort of, you know, the Series 14 minifigs, they have a, like, they have a Banshee that has that piece. And so the more that I looked into it, it's Ninjago has been using that piece for a long time.
Did not know that. So we get to the set, and as you can see, it's almost, this is like a Lego City piece, so I imagine a lot of Lego City people will be buying it to just plug right in, because it would not look out of place. Mm-hmm. Everything's to scale, but this is just one mammoth set. Tons of little rooms, stairways, the fire hose down there as well, but there's tons of detail.
It's a big set.
It's a huge set, man. Really big set. It is a huge set. So I think it's a good 2.5-3 feet tall. But you get some amazing detail on the set, this little winding fire hose. So the figures can twist around it. But look at that detail. It's got a carton of milk in the fridge.
Huh.
Well, actually in the freezer, to be honest. But yeah, they're sitting having pizza there. But there's even a little cereal box. Just beautiful, beautiful detail on this set. Then again, it is $400, so it's a fair spend. Slimer again with a little...
What's that, like a 12 bag build? 10, 12 bag build or something like that? What was the Death Star, 10 bags?
I can't remember.
I don't know. I just know that it was multiple boxes within the box.
I just remember it was gray. There was just never-ending gray. It's great fun, though. Lots of gray bricks, but it was a lot of stuff, a lot of work. So there we go. I don't know. Is that like jam or something? You know, there's a little toaster. Nice idea.
Mm-hmm.
I love all this detail. Little jars in the kitchen and the cereal. I mean, again, just for those stickers alone, I think people will just go nuts for this set. Lots of little maps of New York. Again, that's just... Oh, in fact, it's not a toaster. It's it's the ghost catcher. But we've got a pool table there, billiards, I guess. What's going on? So, again, it's just the thought that's going into this by the guys at LEGO. They've had a blast doing this. There we go. More little scientific experiments going on. A little boogie box there in the corner. A little computer going on there as well. It's just fantastic. Again, more shots of minifigures. It seems light on the stickers, but good-looking stickers as well, so... People will be all over that little arcade machine.
That was my favorite part.
Me too.
The little arcade machine.
It was something that I didn't really pick up on until recently somebody posted it, but if you notice the arcade item that's in there, it's the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man. He's rendered in 8-bit. That's detail that you just don't get in a lot of sets. So, yeah, that alone, I mean, I can see that selling for like $30-$40 alone.
Yeah,
so.
That's going to get parted out.
It's crazy, just for that little set. And look at this, there's Slimer slaming over the toilet. I've never seen this before where they've used mirror bricks on anything that I can recall. But nice use of the bricks again for a basin and a shower, I guess, and the bathroom tiles. It's just, it just goes on and on, all the kind of playability in the set. And there's ghosts or pictures on the wall of... That's from Ghostbusters 2, the baddie there. Can't remember his name. Vigo, the mighty Vigo, I think it was. But yeah, there's the set and all
Lewis,
the details as well.
Lewis.
Brandon's name. Thank you.
Yeah.
And you know what comes to...
And Janine was Annie Potts.
That's right.
Janine.
So it's just down to Pink Ghost and Blue Ghost and Library Ghost. But yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 12 minifigures. So a little bit less than the... Death Star. But there you go, nice reversible faces, which I didn't realize.
If you go back, I think that silver thing might have been the toaster, because they had just had the trap on the ground in front in that picture you had.
Oh, you're right. It looks like one of the traps.
In the movie they poured some of the slime into the toaster, and then they played music, and
that's right,
and it bopped around, you know.
Oh, did they?
Yeah.
In the second one, in Ghostbusters 2.
Yeah, so it seems like they're kind of covering
all the movies.
More than one movie with this one firehouse.
Well, I mean, it's made me get back into Ghostbusters a little bit, watching the movie again and just enjoying it. But it's a beautiful, beautiful set. Really keeping my eye on this one as to potentially get it, because that little Ghostbusters arcade and all the minifigures. Yeah. Alone. I mean, again, even buying that and breaking that for those 12 minifigures, because of the uniqueness of the two-headed sculpt, the whole your girlfriend's a dog face, the twist it around there. That's nice.
I feel like this is going to be one of those sets that just once it sells out and they retire it, it's just going to go up and up in value.
Yeah, this is the college fund one, I think, to buy. Get that one sold. But it's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful set. So Lego PR, thanks to them for sending across some really beautiful high-res images. They're absolutely whopping size. They're like 6,000 pixels. So if you want to, in the gallery that we'll share in the show notes, that you can go and you can download all of these if you want to drill over them like I was.
I noticed on the box that's the age range on that one, 16 plus too.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well, it's a huge set. It's intricate. It's a lot of detail going on. So yeah, you're right. Actually, it's a good point. I've never seen a mature set like that in a long time. So you do need the Ecto One in some ways because the Ecto One slides right into the bay in the bottom, so it's not nice. Included. So you do need to buy that extra set if you want to have it in the bay. And there's the doorway down there. And again, your Ecto One can sit in there. So it's a kind of accessory companion piece. But yeah, just I think it's $399 or $397 is the price that I've seen for this. But I haven't yet seen it on Lego.com. I think it's coming early January, or it's up there saying it's coming in early January. So
yeah.
So, yes, anyone watching, by all means, if you're rich and a millionaire, please buy one for the three of us. That would be fantastic.
Yeah, we'll review it.
We'll review it for you, absolutely. So, yeah, that's good fun. So, more Star Wars, back to that. Oh, I've gone all out of focus there. Let me come back to that in a second. But there is the next thing we've got in the show notes there, which was we're getting another Star Wars book. With another exclusive minifigure. So DK Books announced this. They seem to do these things like so regularly. It's crazy. But we're getting another book, Chronicles of the Force. Not quite sure what's going on there. I kind of get the feeling that's going to include some of the Yoda Chronicles, I'm maybe guessing, and the recent TV shows that we had. But we're getting another minifigure in there. So I'm sure on Amazon that thing will be as cheap as chips.
Yep.
I think from memory, the last one I bought, I think, ended up being like $11 or something.
Yeah, they get pretty low.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then the ones that don't sell, if you remember, like Costco or Sam's Club, they just flood them around Christmas. So right now, if you go to Sam's Club, you'll see a bunch of Lego books that include minifigs.
Yep.
And that if that figure is one, say, that nobody can really recognize, I kind of predict an Old Man Jack figure. If anybody watches the show, you know, Jek was that Sith clone that they made, and he ended up becoming
good
with a little blue arm, but he kind of had a larger role as he became older in some of those cartoons. So an Old Man Jek figure, unfortunately, will drive the price of that book down further when nobody buys it.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just, if it's a popular original trilogy character, people will buy the book more than if it is something wacky that they've never seen before. That's the way it goes.
It might wind up, I mean, looking at that outline, just if I had to guess, it might be Lando, because Lando was sort of like that hidden character from the droid tales.
Yeah.
That's a good point, actually. We've not had a Lando in a long time. Excuse my camera has just decided to go into complete fuzziness because of zooming in.
You're filming the show on a potato.
I can see.
No, I'm like fuzz. It's because we're shooting the Lego Ghostbusters stuff. There's just steady to go all crazy.
I could also see that if they wanted to do a Lego figure, releasing that with the Droid Tales DVD though.
Yeah, it's true.
Because the way they did the little young Han Solo Ian figure with the Padawan Menace one. I mean, you never know what's going to happen, but
yep,
for a selling point figure. So.
So, Lego Star Wars Chronicles, that's coming out soon. Let's just see what else we got here in our show notes. We also had another Star Wars Lego piece, which was, and we showed it briefly earlier on, but two new little sets that popped up in social, I should say, was, I think, again, it was Hothbricks. We were talking about them earlier on. Before the show, but the Finn poly bag and the little X-Wing standalone are coming out. Image will just load in just one sec. But there we go, some kind of dodgy images, but they leaked out a little while back. But super excited to get that Finn there, but I don't know whether he's going to come with a helmet, which was a little...
I bet he doesn't.
I know. That would be a
bummer. I wish he would, obviously, but...
You know, the interesting thing, someone pointed this out online, and it makes a lot of sense, is if you look at that bag, it's definitely smaller than the other, and it has a little, almost like an unlock sort of, you know...
Ziploc top.
Blue bar on there, on the lower right, and that kind of poly bag usually comes in with a game, so that might wind up being like a new Lego Star Wars game.
Well, that 3PO poly bag is a lot smaller than the ship bag though too.
Yeah, well that's true. I just think that the last time we saw a poly bag like that with the little lock in the corner
with the lip, yeah,
was the Dr. Wu that came with the Lego Jurassic Park game.
Hmm. So what game would it come with? That would be the question.
Might be a new Lego Star Wars. We might get an updated version of it. It would be right to get one.
Yeah.
It'd be weird that we haven't heard anything about it, but...
That's true. But then maybe keeping everything quiet, I could imagine by the time Lego Star Wars The Force, or Lego The Force Awakens comes out, maybe on Blu-ray around about May or Easter time,
mm-hmm.
I'm sure... Telltale, Tolt, whatever they're called, Interactive, the company behind the Lego games. I'm sure they can maybe come out with a game at some point. But they're cool little sets. No real word yet as to where we can get them, but you're right, Matt, about that potential, that blue little unlock. We've seen that before a couple of times on game sets too. So
I bet it's an exclusive with kind of the way that 3PO is rolling right now. Well, nothing crazy about the 3PO, but... You could, you know, buy X amount of dollars and get a free Stormtrooper Finn. Yeah.
It's funny that 3PO said, just talking about, I saw a pile of them in a local Toys R Us recently. There one day at $3.99, and then the next day all had been scalped and gone. Every single one of them, like 20 of them. I don't know if they turned up in stores for you guys at all, or...
Oh, yeah. There's a ton around me now. When they first dropped, before the promo sort of, you know, came about, they were flying. And then the promo, they took them all behind the customer service. And then after the promo was done, they put them out. And there's more than plenty at my Toys R Us right now.
Well, that's to be expected. But I'm sure the price will be driven down pretty cheaply over time. What else have we got to cover? Star Wars. I think we're nearly done with the major kind of news. But the Amazon, well, it's been selling out like crazy on Amazon, but the Advent calendar, which I'll just share on screen with you just now. Did you guys pick that up, the Lego Star Wars one?
Yep.
I did, and we picked this up months ago. As soon as it went on sale on Amazon, we ordered it, we got it, we were all excited about it, and then Wyatt's Oma, basically one of his grandmothers, went and got him this Advent calendar.
Playmobil.
It was one of those that he Skypes with his Oma every other day, and the excitement of opening that with Oma has quenched us even opening the Lego Advent calendar. So... The Advent calendar sits in my office, just waiting.
What?
Waiting patiently.
Oh, my God.
The thing about these, I mean, there's, you know, 24 days, so I could use it for any kind of 24-day countdown. I could use it next year. I could use it. So it hasn't been opened. It's sitting here, but we do have it.
Well, it's one that I think you might want to even put in the college fund Lego box, because this damn thing is going up in price. It's been super popular. I think, obviously, fueled by this little independent movie that no one's heard of coming out on December 18th.
Right.
But it was $34.99, I think it was originally. It's now nearly double in price, and it has just not been keeping up in sale. eBay sent me an email today and said, hey, if you're selling stuff online, here's the top 10 things that people want. This was in the top 10. So,
I believe it. So yeah, I was really surprised at how quick it sold out on Lego's online store, and that sort of...
The thing is, they're still at Toys R Us. You can still walk into Toys R Us and pick one up.
Well, there you go. I mean, buy one at Toys R Us and put it on Amazon.
That depends. I might have to.
I mean, I think that depends on your area, because my area, they've been cleared out.
Yeah. Yeah.
Even on eBay, I looked tonight just before the show, just trying to do a little quick mini research on it. $54.99 was the time for the average price, I should say, that it was going for. So it's nuts to think this is going for so much money. But I've started kind of opening up. They're all open one day, but so far, meh. But there's a little preview of some of the
sets we talked about. Are those items in order?
No, they are not. They are not. They're all randomly asserted. So any day that it turns up, but there you go. There's a little E-wing in there. So
what was day one?
Day one was Jabba's sail barge, and it's super lame. So it really is. I was like, what?
It's those micro builds.
So what was day two?
I don't know. I haven't even had a chance to open it yet. So I've got day two and three to open. So super excited. There we go. But yeah, it's a little sparse on great minifigures, but
what did we end up counting? There was about 8 minifigures in the pack, 8 to 10.
It's not true.
There's like 6 or 7 maybe.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 8 if you want to call one of those little droids. So yeah, it's a little sparse, I think, on cool stuff, so. But it's been probably the most successful calendar yet. So
yeah.
So you go. I mean, Lego make it more. I'm sure they will. But it's, you know, it's an advent calendar. It's kind of past its usefulness, I think, by now. So.
Well, I mean, the one redeeming quality of this advent calendar is it does have the original trilogy Stormtrooper and Jawa, and both of those minifigs actually came from either the Sandcrawler UCS set, which is really expensive, mm-hmm. or the Star Destroyer for the Stormtrooper. So you pretty much couldn't get these any other way. So those are actually pretty nice that they put those figures in. They didn't just put some, you know, run-of-the-mill ones you can get from Microfighters or things like
sure.
that.
Sure, sure, sure. We got a nice little Trooper in there with leg print, and that Hoth Rebel Trooper is, I think his white coat is unique to that set. I don't recall seeing that anywhere as of yet. And of course you get Santa 3PO in there too, so spoiler alert, it's on the front of the box, so.
Yeah.
But and this reminded me of a Saturday Night Live sketch, the way that guy's holding that box there, but never mind. Moving on. So that's the kind of that's just some general news.
Are you saying it's his brick in a box?
It's his brick in a box. There you go.
He spins it too.
It's my brick in a box. So yes, there's plenty of sites doing a one a day review. If you're not buying the set, some people are reviewing like the mini Jabba sail barge. I didn't waste my time really, but it's there. So there's tons of other news as well that's been out there, but that was just a sampling of some of the stuff we found. So, moving on to some non-news, but some other stuff that's out there, some customs and bits and pieces. This was one, and again, if you're looking for links, they're in the show notes here, LEGO Ideas. There's some really cool stuff that's been arriving up on LEGO Ideas. Always a great place to go and look at some stuff. But this was a sampling of some of the sets that had been put up for review in the recent months or recent times. So Frozen, some airplanes, some huge dinosaurs, some amazing looking stuff, but these ones I think have all been rejected. I think that's what the gigantic Red Cross was. But the Doctor Who set, these are ones which have been approved to go ahead, I believe, or the results, they're through to the next round, I should say. So still a dinosaur, a Stay Puft guy, huge Stay Puft guy there. A modular library, The Hobbit, Rivendell, a huge asset there as well. So there's tons of stuff up on LEGO Ideas. Well, there's a few more links. We'll talk about that later on. But Adventure Time LEGO, it just never seems to end with LEGO in terms of some of the creativity that people do for these LEGO Ideas sets. Iron Man is still incredibly popular. It's one of the ones which... so yes, more for that would be good. Open that other link. So one set, I don't know if we talked about this before, I think there's a magazine, Hesper Bricks, which is a beautiful thick PDF of LEGO stuff, and they featured about a year ago a set which is a red motorbike from Akira, if you know the science fiction movie, the anime movie. And this set was so popular, it was gorgeous. I shared it on social at the time. Tons of people were sharing this thing. We'll get this link up on the screen in just a sec. But this caused a global shortage of red bricks of a certain kind for this set.
Wow.
And they've made another set. So anyway, this the guy behind this set here who made this, this was the image based, this red kind of bike, just beautifully made with little stickers, very Ferrari-looking little bike from Akira. And it did cause, as I said there, a worldwide shortage on some of these red bricks. They literally just vanished as soon as this set came out. But the guy is back who made this book and these images and this little set, and he's done something else. There's a little set that we were talking about just now, which is just gorgeous. They got to bring that thing out, man. That's a Lego idea in its own. But they have made a follow-up to that, which, again, is in our show notes. Hopefully I've got it there. To Alien, which
I've seen this, yeah.
It's just stunning. So we're talking about Alien, the movie. So the same guy behind that, the Canada's bike, has made this. So it's basically he's made this set, this Alien set, and he's created this 200-page hardback book on the making of and the instructions. This is real Lego porn. It's it's really something else. So instructions on how to build this. It lets you go into, obviously, Bricklink and build all this stuff. It looks a little dull because it's really a lot of black bricks, but you get this gorgeous, I know you're a big Alien fan like me, Matt.
Oh, yeah. When I saw this,
yeah,
I was really blown away. I mean, there's even like a little bit of acid drool coming out of its mouth. I mean, it's just this. I think looking at some of these pictures, they definitely don't do it justice. I think it's something that you'd have to see in person. It happens that way with any sets that are really primarily one color or one type of you know, shade or whatever. They don't really come across as well in pictures.
No, I definitely know it. But
did it say it was 1,526 pieces? Is that what it said? Scroll up a little bit. I thought it had this right there. Let's see. Yeah. Down a little bit. It was right that bit. It was a short blur between two pictures.
Right, 150 pages.
Right there.
You're right. 1,526 parts.
That's and then another 466 for the base.
Yes.
Yeah.
So the base is
2,000 parts.
I know. That's
a lot kind of black bricks.
That's filed off the kind of I guess the airlock hatch in Aliens where the
yeah.
Well, I don't know whether this is supposed to be the queen or not. I don't think it is, but regardless, it's beautiful. It's absolutely gorgeous. So, yeah, it's something else when you're making a hardback book about a 200-page hardback book about a Lego set that you know it's something kind of special. So yeah, that's just his foot alone. But the detail's gorgeous, and it's got working functional parts, and as Matt said, it drool. A little bit of gooey drool there, which is gorgeous. Articulated drool, by the way. So, very, very clever indeed. So again, Hesper Bricks, a great resource for this kind of stuff. If you really want some kind of hardcore builds and Lego, it's a great free magazine, which is online to get this stuff. There's another little quick look at the Flickr gallery for book porn there for this thing. You can see the little corner of the book. It's a little sexy tease. Isn't that awesome? And all the little colors and thoughts they put in. So yeah, it stands on that earlock piece there. Yeah. Blueprints of it. Little backgrounds is the drill, how you make the drill aspect. But
yeah, it's so amazing to see stuff like this. And in the back of your mind, you're just thinking Lego would never touch this in a million years. Like anything with a certain amount of violence and you know, gore, they'll never touch it. Somebody posted on a forum recently that they got a letter back for a they did like a little custom Chucky doll, and Lego immediately told them to pull it down from the Lego Ideas website because it was never going to get approved. So
wow. Well, look, I mean, that's their right to do so. I mean, they're definitely, it's a kid's product, and they've always said that they're not going to do sets with war and that kind of stuff. So, you know, never mind, there's a war in Star Wars, but never mind. So, yeah, I get the point, but yeah. So while looking at those gorgeous images of that alien, this also caught my eye as well. I just get led on to link and thought you guys might like this. I chucked this in the show notes here. It's called the Patent Office. I talked about this on the Realm Recap, the Star Wars podcast we do the other night, because there's tons of Star Wars stuff in here too.
Yeah.
There's. You guys seen this?
Yeah. I've seen it. I think there's some really cool stuff on that with some of the patent blueprints and some of the designs that some people do with some of that artwork. And you can get it, you know, any size you want. I think all the way from 5x7 up to, I don't know if it's 24x36, whatever the size is, but they've got some really cool, really cool stuff, which, you know, some of those would be great. Yeah, that's great, you know, I don't want to say sofa art, but great, you know, great centerpiece for a living room that it's a good talking point for art as opposed to just buying some field of flowers or something lame.
Yeah, exactly. And the price on this, which is the interesting
point. They're dirt ass cheap for something like that.
They really are. It's fantastic. But there's one in here. I think I've lost the actual item because there is literally tons of them in here. But there are brick. Like it's an explosion of a little mini brick. I'll show you one that they've done. There's the Aliens Power Loader. So it's a print. I think it's about A4 in size, but it's like a blueprint that you would have at a patent office. But you can get it in kind of full fake aged kind of print.
Yeah, I think they have it. They have it. You could either get a chalkboard, blueprint, or drawn design. I think those are the three. Yeah. Chalkboard, vintage, or blueprint. Yeah.
There you go. So, and they're only $8. That's incredible. So there's some dimensions there as well. So yeah, just 5 to 7 inches.
4x36, $38 or something like that. I mean, that's a, you know.
A real conversation piece, something different that you could have on your wall. There is a Lego in there. I'm trying to see if the... Yeah, search Lego.
Search shirt, yeah, there you go.
We had a nice little minifigure explosion, I think it was. We had a blueprint. Oh, there we go. That's the one. They just moved them around in the homepage. This was the one I caught my eye. Yeah, it's a nice... I mean, there's a lot of the stuff these days. I mean, Matt, you're wearing a Lego t-shirt tonight. I was out at a Mexican restaurant that I called
Chewy's.
Chewy's. You guys have them around you, and they have Lego t-shirts there. So it's, you know, loving your fandom is as much as wearing it is building it. So, but that's beautiful. I really like the kind of vintage style they've got on that set of bricks there. So yeah.
You know what's interesting is just sort of a side note and sort of partially related, but I saw a link earlier today of on Target's website. They have a they're having a sale on Lego blueprint t-shirts. So if you want something that's pretty much identical to some of those ones that shows the, was it 2x4, and it, they show basically how it interlocks and that, you can get a t-shirt officially made by Lego. And I think it's only $9 on Lego on the Target website. So it looks pretty cool.
That's good. I love that stuff, and it's something I'll always try and, if I can find it, I'll chuck it in your front notes or share it out, because, yeah, like you said, it's as much as playing with the toys as it's, you know, collecting your t-shirts are great when I'm wearing a Star Wars t-shirt, and a vintage Kenner Star Wars t-shirt, and it's, yeah, I love all that stuff. But there's a ton, Lego have been pretty good, they've outsourced a lot of their stuff quite heavily overseas. They don't make things like pencil holders and... those giant head, the Lego minifigure head that you can pour all your loose Lego in if you're a kid. That's outsourced. It's not made by Lego, but they license it out to a couple of companies throughout the world.
Yeah.
Stuff. And they go nuts for that stuff. Stationery. Matt, you and I saw a lot of that at Legoland California this year. There was just all that stuff is not made by Lego. A lot of it is outsourced.
Even the parks, you know, it's interesting because there's sort of, there was on sort of a weird, sort of almost ridiculous type of side note is that the company that technically owns the parks is an entertainment company called Merlin, and the largest stakeholders in Merlin are the family that owns Lego, and it was just sort of interesting because I read this week that Merlin actually donated a ton of money to a child's development program that is through Scientology, so this sort of like made its way through sort of the forums, and then people were like, oh my god, Lego's you know, donating to Scientology, but technically they weren't, so it was, I don't know, it's sort of weird how much were they involved with that. Was it just Merlin? You know, it's you know, look it up. It's it was part of like a recent tree lighting ceremony, they announced the donation as well. So.
Well, I should have shown pictures here where my hometown, Melbourne in Australia, had in the square that they have. It's a local, it's a huge city, but in the square they had a Lego tree, was one of the core kind of things they launched. And they do a lot of that over, I don't know why, in Australia, one of the hottest places right now at this time of year. They do Christmas trees and all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, yeah. But,
yeah, there's the, I'm just sharing.
Yeah, I sent you a picture of the link.
Yeah, well, I found one here just on the web. Legoland Park in California sparks outrage with a donation to Scientology group. Well, I mean, if anybody's got the money, it's Lego and Scientology. So, and there's some bling for your dog. That's bizarre. But, yes, so, yeah, I'm sure they'll distance themselves very quickly from that. And if they were thinking of renewing their contract with the theme park company, then... Yeah, that may come up in conversation, I think. So.
Yeah, this was just sort of a head scratcher, especially with the HBO documentary that came out, and all the backlash that they've been actually getting on a larger stage recently, and for them to kind of do this, and not think that it was going to bring all this bad PR. It's just sort of like the Ah Weiwei debacle that they had. I don't know if you know about that activist, the artist activist in China who tried to. A bulk order from Lego, and then Lego turned him down because they said we're not part of political artwork, and it wasn't that they were against actually like letting him buy Lego. They just didn't want to sell it with the intention that he was going to use it in a way that sort of like twisted its meaning, and it made sense because someone actually wrote an article about how they've had sort of a burned relationships before with other artists that have taken their Lego and then made like fake boxes and made it look all official, like Lego was actually supporting
the sponsor behind it, right?
Yeah, like a sponsoring their message, and maybe their message was real, you know, wasn't even mainstream, and so it just they're just trying to stay out of it, and I can understand that. I mean,
well, nobody's going to look at something like that when they see something made of Legos and go, oh, well, they didn't use real Legos, they used Flegos. I mean, so they're going to associate that it was made with Legos with the consent from Lego.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, if he has enough.
I totally understand that.
Yeah.
No. Well, it's a good point, and I did see that response from Lego as well. And they were really—they just want to be—they kind of want to be Switzerland on everything. They just, you know, we don't want to get into controversy on anything at all. And I don't blame them. It's everything can be a PR disaster these days. One tweet, and you know, your company can just be, yeah, things can go really wrong very quickly. And Lego have a lot of money sitting on things, so yeah, they got to be careful. So I don't blame them. This was something we were just talking about, the Lego Christmas tree, just very briefly. It's the largest Lego tree or just Lego ornament in the southern hemisphere there. It's in Melbourne's Fed Square, a beautiful place this time of year. Built for Australian Lego fans, the tree is 10 meters tall. I don't know what that is in American bizarre feet, inches language. But the 10 meters is a lot.
Yeah.
That's pretty tall. Yeah. So, and there's a guy there who lives in Melbourne, master builder Chris Stenger. He's one of the only people, I think. Maybe it's not. There's one Lego master builder in Australia that I know of, but this is someone else then, perhaps. But he's joining in to launch this there. So, yeah, from the 27th of November right through to Christmas, if you're in Australia, go and have a look at that. The Lego Christmas tree is massive. It really is. I've seen a lot better photographs than I saw there, but yeah, it's a pretty big piece. And there's another shot there, I think. I'm trying to get a better image. Yeah, that's Fed Square in the background. Yeah, it's big. There's a human being there, and there's a gigantic figure. So it's a big-ass piece, and there's a sleigh, candy cane, and so forth. So yeah, it's gigantic. Cool. So that was that. What else do we have to cover? We talked about Lego Ideas. We talked about IKEA. Manufacturing Blueprints. Lego, the Droid Tales. Did you guys watch the last one, the most recent one? Did you catch up on that at all?
Mm-hmm. I think, yeah. I think, what, five episodes? Yeah. I think
five. Yep, no, five was the final one I hadn't seen. If look, it's out there on YouTube. It's not as if we're promoting piracy, but if you want to watch it, they're online. You can get a look at them there. There's some very funny moments in these. I had some real laugh out loud moments watching number five. Have you seen it, Matt? Have you?
Yeah, no, I loved them. I loved them that the fact that it they did actually position the storyline like shortly after Return of the Jedi, so it kind of has a nice lead into almost Force Awakens. Said
yeah,
you know, they kind of put it in that sweet spot about, you know, they're cleaning up from the party and, you know, the whole celebration, and it kind of even hints at the fact that the Empire is still around in pockets, and you know, it wasn't completely eradicated with the destruction of the Death Star or the killing of the Emperor. So it's kind of interesting because, I mean, up to this point, there's always sort of been that underlying narrative that after the Emperor died and after the Death Star, the second Death Star was destroyed, the Empire was like basically just threw down their arms and gave up, you know? And now we're kind of getting that different narrative now that, you know, there was still a fight going on even after that, so.
I love the, yet again, we see Jar Jar, spoiler alert there for folk watching,
but yeah.
We see him floating by in a couple, it's just, I just love the way they've dealt with that.
Oh, and they rail on him.
Fun. They railed on him, they really did.
Yeah, every episode they rail on him.
But Palpatine was really good in this episode. I loved his kind of constantly mocking Vader and trying to outsmart him, and you won't be as skilled as Han Solo. It's just really well written, this thing. So whoever's doing the writing is doing a great job. It's already available to buy in video or DVD format, I should say, and in separate episodes as well. There's a link here again in the show notes. If you watch it, you can watch it on Amazon Video. They have season one where you can see all of them, I believe. Or you can buy it on DVD, I believe, and it's only one or two episodes per DVD, which is a little bit of a bummer. So let me just clarify on that one there. But yeah, I think the season on Amazon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes, you can watch all five at $3.
Yeah, you get all five out of it then. On the DVD, right?
It's
one. Buying it online.
You can get this is just the digital version.
That's the digital version. Okay.
So I'm not sure whether it's on iTunes. I just saw it first of all on Amazon, but. Yeah, it's $10 for the entire five episodes, or $3.99, or YouTube. So
yeah, and if you have Disney XD, you can also. It's almost like on demand. You can go back and watch that. So
it's still available. Yeah.
Yeah, you got multiple ways to watch this.
But I'm surprised this didn't. I mean, it does say it's coming out on March 1st, 2016. That this, I'm sure it'll be the case, but they'll have a little minifigure attached to the front of that. But I think this is all finally five episodes on the. DVD, and it's marked on Amazon. It's $20, but I'm sure that will come down in price.
No, it's going to come down. It's going to come down.
Many figures stuck on the front of that for sure. So if you want it, pre-order it. Just a couple more links, and then I think we are done. Some Flago turned up when I was having my annual search around. Amazon seems to be a place for this at the moment. For some reason, it seems to be a lot of. Lego sellers, fake Lego we're talking about, if you've never watched it, let's talk about that before. But Mickey Mouse was getting some Lego treatment the other day, I don't know why. I think they've changed the link, I mean, that's what they've done. It's gone. Which may have happened. Oh well, we'll have a look and
go let me see.
And find that. This turned up though in some of my searches for Lego here, which I'd never seen before. And again, I don't know whether this is fake or not, but I've never seen a promotional set for The Force Awakens. I'm thinking it's fake, but we get these little cards here. I mean, it looks legit. There's a little Disney logo down at the bottom and Lucasfilm and so forth, but this was kind of interesting, these little promo cards. Kind of reminded me of the older sets that you would get for Lego that came with stands, where you would slot the cards into the back of the
I've never seen this before.
No, neither have I. So that's what I was saying. I don't know whether it was a fake or not.
It seems like a U.S. seller, so that would sort of lend some credibility. And they are using the stock photography, but I mean, then they are using all of the copyright information at the bottom on the back. So it probably would. It's a very, very real possibility. I mean, Lego produces so much promotional material. and you know, so many different like, little packs and box sets. I mean, just recently going to Kohl's, I discovered another different book packed in with minifigs, and they actually have one that has three minifigs packed into it. So
yes, I still thought, yeah.
You know, there's this bunch of stuff that doesn't show up on the radar, on the larger radar, and I'm interested to know more about these cards. I've never.
I bet it's a pack. You know, just one of those freebie packs to buy X amount of dollars and get Lego cards to complement your.
I mean, this might be an overseas thing too. I mean, this kind of feels like an overseas, maybe like a UK or a Germany.
A magazine insert or something like that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very. Yeah, that's a big possibility. Is that it's just not here in the US.
Well, it reminded me of an older set that I always remember. Picking up years ago in a cafe, and I made there offhand, but it was I think it was a Biker Scout. There was one that came with Boba Fett, a little small card, and it would slot into a grey stand, and you could basically have a nice little diorama that was kind of an L shape, and you would slot your minifigure in there. It was a nice little display. One side had a picture of a Sarlacc, and you flipped it over, and on the back it was a mini bio of Boba Fett and some of the characters and stuff. So
this guy's charging a lot for those cards.
Yeah, for five little cards.
It's like $6 a car plus shipping, you know, it's like
Yeah, Lego and promo. So yeah, one other one that turned up in the Flego pile was Mickey Mouse and all things. So never seen this before.
God, that looks like a ghetto Mickey.
Yeah.
Ghetto Mickey. And many as well, so yeah, kind of bizarre, but
we call him Mickey Donaldino. No.
This is Mickey from Tijuana.
That's what it is. That's the screen print they use to get your Mickey shirt when you go to Tijuana.
It pretty much looks like it. But,
like Minnie's eyes are drifting.
That is the epitome of a Flego picture right there with those giant yellow stands you had there. That is as Flego as you want to be right there.
Flego and bread.
And these self-destruct on you know on delivery.
They look like they use petroleum where you can slide them and just boom.
I love how Donald Duck comes with some of the Simpsons Flanders set, the little box and the mug, and so they're retooling some of their Flego Simpson stuff. And Mickey comes with Lisa's saxophone.
Saxophone, yeah.
This is just hilarious.
Going on there. Any G in the Mickey Mouse world. But,
yeah, I don't remember him being a sax player.
No, it is. I like the fake Lego colors there, and the, you know, trying to replicate the Lego there, as if GLB is going to be a logo or a name you'll remember. But it's really interesting to see this stuff. It's very underground, but it's just fun to kind of see all this stuff. And I'm still a proponent of Lego. Yes, I understand it's fake products. And
you're like the anti brick show. I feel like you're the guy heralding the cheapness and the economy of getting Lego, and there's the brick show trying to shut you down.
If you want a Mickey just to display, this is still not it.
Hold on, if this was Iron Man, well, I know. But we were talking about this before, we might as well mention it. The brick show did a feature. I kind of felt they went on a major rant. It was almost like a plug
for Lego they did sort of like to catch a predator. They went undercover and they went to the, you know, because the thing is that if you go to any convention these days, you're going to see fake Lego. It's just the way it is. Even at Anaheim Celebration, right across from the Lego booth, we saw a guy selling Flego. So if it's that prevalent, we're right across from Lego, they're selling it. You know, they're not going to stop it. Even Lego is throwing their hands up and says, okay, you know what, China's going to do what China's going to do. You know, if they're going to bootleg our stuff, they're going to bootleg our stuff. So
I feel it's a little bit like if I were to walk through a TSA environment through a kind of scanner or something, and I was ISIS. Go on through, if you know pirate movies. Go on through, Flego up against the wall. They felt really heavy-handed on this seller, and it was a little overboard. I thought their video a little bit.
Don't get me wrong. I'm a Lego enthusiast. I'm like super hardcore. I mean, I think I only have maybe one or two fake Lego or what I would even call customs. But I could totally understand the opposite end of why people want to get Flego, especially with Iron Man. And and the limited run of what they've actually even done. I mean, they never even did a Mark One. They never even did half of these awesome suits that he's got from Iron Man 3. And you know, and if China's going to be the one to actually produce it in a quality manner, then why not? You know, it is what it is. You know, it's your collection. You do what you want. So.
Exactly. So, yeah, fake Minnie Mouse and Mickey, if you want them, then they're out there. So, but to end up, there's another Flego set. I haven't seen any new Iron Man ones in the world, but this turned up. And the picture's not great quality, but I have seen a better picture floating around, and we'll get a little review the next time because I bought a set. So
you bought this?
Not that price, but I bought this little set here. So you're getting a Sabine, General Hux, a something Imperial officer in black there, Kylo Ren, with his hood down and one kind of standard hood that goes.
The Stormtrooper looks a little dodgy.
Stormtrooper definitely looks dodgy. Space Wars is what it says there. There's a better, slightly better picture. Yeah, dodgy little kind of.
So did you receive this already, or
not yet? No, it's coming from China, so it was on eBay. Yeah, first of all, in this case, it was like $10 for all of these from China delivered.
I like that droid.
That's what I thought. And the little BB-8.
Yeah, that's the Rebel
droid. Yeah, a droid and a BB-8.
Yeah. Those are the two figures everybody wanted from that. What is it? It's like a gunship or something from Rebels, that large set that came with Sabine and that clear-headed
astromech. Like an Imperial cruiser or something like that, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So we'll do a Flego in hand review in the next show. I thought these were kind of worth for $10. Ship. Just like, my God, I gotta give this a go. So
why'd you get it? Did you get it for the Kylo Ren?
What's that?
Did you get it for Kylo Ren?
Pretty much. I mean, yes. I mean, the Kylo Ren was. I mean, again, and a little bit of blame goes, I think, to Lego as well. In some ways, it's like you made one of the most popular figures, incredibly hard and expensive to get in your set, which I understand, but that's a little bit. They fisted for a lot of young kids who want that, so a little collector, so they could have made another set with Kylo at a lower price point, but he's coming in another set, but it's another expensive set, so I hear the point of piracy, but at the same time, if you make things hard to get, well, you know, you're going to get people who will copy your sugar. It's going to happen, whether you like it or not. So, had Kylo been in a little battle pack for like $12.99, you probably would not have seen as much of these sell. But same with Sabine. This is a Sabine with a helmet, and she came in that really extortionate set.
And this is how easy it is. In the time we were talking, I just bought that set as well. I just went to eBay, and I just bought that set.
Oh, my God.
There you go.
So, we can kiss the Lego endorsements goodbye.
This is just called journalistic integrity. That's all we're doing.
I got my Sabine helmet. I got a droid. I got a BB-8. You name it, I got it.
We show the underbelly. We show the top.
This is it. It's not just the product stuff.
When you wait till 10 o'clock at night Central Time, we drink and we buy shit on eBay.
So yeah, there you go. So talking about buying stuff, that's us in terms of just some of the links we've got. Again, everything's in the show notes, is pretty much there. What did you guys buy, Scott? You just bought a set, obviously, but
I bought a set of Flego Force Awakens figures.
What did you been buying?
Confirmation has not even come through. That's how
fresh it ran.
I bought polybag tie.
Nice.
Which are extremely plentiful at Target. They are in an end cap near the Lego section, and another section, they usually have a little end cap with some miscellaneous Legos on it, facing electronics. They had a ton. I bought two, one for myself and one to send to a friend who's going through some rehab, and he said Legos are great because he can get his fingers moving for his rehab, so I sent one to him. Nice. The Advent calendar, picked up a 3PO. $4 for a couple of 3POs and bought two, and one for the box and one to keep. But that's really, I mean, it's been
when they go
dry, but I'm more frothing at the mouth for all the minifigure sets that are coming out, little battle packs and new microfighters than anything else. Everything else sitting on the shelf, you know, watching for great deals. Everybody's had their, you know, buy at $25 worth and get a free whatever the hell it was at Target. And but pretty much I'm just keeping my eyes peeled on what's going to either hit the clearance closer and closer to the holidays, or Amazon's notorious for running hot deals on whether it be Legos or anything else as it gets closer and closer, and with Prime shipping you get it in 2 days. So we're kind of watching online for a lot of stuff more than in stores. So
yeah, speaking of sales, they are closing some Kmarts around the country, and I've seen pictures from people just clearing them out, and so they're liquidating at the Kmarts that they're closing. They're liquidating the Lego. So
great,
really good deal. If you know a Kmart, go start looking around there for Lego because they're moving it.
Okay, good to know. What about you? What have you been buying Lego wise?
Nothing too crazy. I got the poly bag as well. So the little tie, I had to get that. It's a really cool little set. And then I actually went to the Toys R Us build event.
Nice.
So for now, you got the little set ready to go. Nice. So these are really cool. These are actually just carbon copies of a previous build that they made for the older X-Wing. So it's really easy to put these together through BrickLink. So I'm also going to be posting like a parts list for this. It's really common parts, nothing special. And the last thing I picked up was, this was actually a set from the Lego store that is showing up in my Toys R Us, and it's kind of what I've been talking about, is that Toys R Us has been sort of like pulling in last year's, you know, seasonal sets, and then they get a bunch of these. They got a bat set for Halloween and that sort of thing. So I just couldn't pass this up. I thought this would be a little cool thing to put on my table for Christmas and that sort of thing. But other than that, that's pretty much it. I'm waiting on some of those new Force Awakens sets and, you know, seeing when those start to hit. I mentioned the one with Kylo Ren without the helmet.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good one. The only set I picked up was the little 3PO minifigure we talked about. I should have waited for it, but I didn't.
I didn't know that was going to be time.
I don't care. I'm glad to get it. I think maybe it was you, Matt, that said, but the head is a completely different plastic from the main body. It's a weird color that we have got. I mean, it's completely better. But
Actually, you know, the funny thing about that is that I've noticed some chatter about people kind of bringing up some of the new minifigs, or, you know, they'll compare like an older Han Solo of the same, you know, basically the same type, like say one from Microfighters and a newer one. Mm-hmm. And what they're noticing is that there's a little bit of a quality difference with the Mexico factory. So the Mexico factory has been sort of supplementing some of the sets, and they're actually producing some of the sets completely in Mexico. And there's faces that are coming a little blurred. The pieces are a little bit different colored. I'm gonna go to guess that the C-3PO is probably made in Mexico, because it seems to be a little bit weird color variation on that. But overall, it's a really good figure, but it's just a little bit difference on the colors.
Yeah, I mean, it just says in the back of the bag that components made in Denmark, Mexico, and China. They're never going to tell us which factory is made in. But, I mean, again, it's different plastic for different parts. His body looks great. He's just a nice gold kind of shiny color. And I think, as we talked about before, it's great to see. And you can't see here, obviously, not very much. But the print on the legs and the arms is something special. It's a, you know, you can print everywhere, literally. You could possibly get print on it. But then you kind of let down with the plastic. It's a very cheap-looking head on the 3PO there. It's a shame, but then it's just a minifigure, so I'm picking holes. But apart from the advent calendar, that was me. I haven't bought any Lego in a while, and I think, like you guys, are waiting for the new sets to come out in the new year. Dying to get my hands in some Battlefront Lego. I'm in that little shock trooper. Trooper sleeves back then.
I wish they had done the Solus Trooper like they did the Force Awakens pilot, where they had a little hose sort of runs into its helmet. They didn't. I felt like that was a missed opportunity, because they just use a standard, classic Stormtrooper helmet with a little bit of weathering on it, but they didn't do the hose, and I just felt that was. They've had a few of those sort of missed opportunities. I think with the, as when we're looking at the microfighters, I felt like the TIE Advanced or the prototype, they should have just packed the Inquisitor in, and forget like putting that pilot that we've pretty much already seen, but now in a Rebels format. You know, it's something that everybody's been wanting. I don't feel like they really need to hold on to the Inquisitor anymore because he's a character that technically died, so why not let kids get him in a cheaper set? You know, it's just, I felt like there's some missed opportunities there.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. Sorry, Scott, you were going to say something there?
No, I was going to say, I agree. I mean, these microfighter sets, especially when they come around, I don't want to say rehashing the ties, especially if you go from advanced to an interceptor to what's next, a bomber, and it's pretty much almost the same build, except for maybe a change in the wings and a little expansion on the bomber, but they could have done the Inquisitor, they could have done Agent Kallus, they could have done, there's so many things they could get these figures back out. We still see Kallus on the show, but the Inquisitor, exactly, he's dead and gone. So
yeah, I don't think we're going to see another set.
And he was only available in a $80 set to start with, so it's a good way to get him back out there and just kind of keep him a bit more relevant in the Lego, but maybe they just want to push him to the side and move on without him. So
it's a kind of weird format with Lego. It's very much the Apple model to me, anyway, personally, where it's kind of like incredibly small iterations every year regularly on figures. You know, there's a print on the arm, then there's a print on the legs, or the head slightly different or improved, and you're buying the same thing again and again and again, almost, it feels like, with very little real major change in the figure. And I get that model, they have to do that to keep it going, but you know, every couple of years, people have forgotten about the older minifigures. It's always about the latest one, so I guess that's where we're going to see
something. I mean, I think they could take a page out of some of the other licenses some of the other companies that own the Star Wars license as well. I feel like with some of these characters, especially like Kylo Ren, as we were talking about, that only comes in a super expensive set, why not have him in a cheaper set, maybe a $20 set, maybe a microfighter or whatever, and then a different variation, or it's more of like a chase figure in the more expensive set, and do that regularly. So do the real baseline figure in a cheaper set, and then, you know, it's kind of like how Hasbro did the Special Forces TIE pilot in the big box set, and they're doing the normal TIE pilot, you know, just on regular card. Why not take that model and do the same thing? So, you know, the guys who are going to spend that much money on a big set, you know, why not, you know, it's sort of like the UCS sets when they do the special minifig in those. Why not just carry that sort of mantra down the line so everybody can get the figures that they want?
Yeah, I agree with you on that, but I think their angle, I think, is, and again, that's what I'm saying, I think it's like the Apple model, is Apple don't really do cheap. Why should they? They just don't want to go into that kind of area. And Lego, I mean, the small sets really are not cheap. They're just small scale, so they're small price. But they seem to be more and more, again, we've talked about this quite a lot, is that when these new sets came out recently, there was very few small sets for The Force Awakens, and maybe that'll be changing in the new year, but yeah, I think they need more lower price budget sets. It's just, if you said there, might just to get more minifigures out, because that's the crack. That's the thing that people really want. I mean,
if they had released all the small sets on, you know, Midnight Madness, no one would have bought the big sets. Put the big sets out, let's get everybody out there, and then we'll do that little dabble of some small sets. And,
well, I mean, I feel like it's the same thing. I mean, a lot of companies kind of pulled that card. Hasbro pulled that card by you know, not releasing the Super Articulate until just now. So everybody who wanted just to have a Force Awakens figure bought into 5POA.
Exactly.
Because they needed to get their hands on something. And then now, they're you know, but if they had Super Articulate at the beginning, a lot less people would have bought 5POA, so it's kind of the same thing. It's kind of like a dirty trick, I feel like. You know, they're holding back these cards and kind of pushing out the stuff that people don't really want as much, and then after you've spent that money, then they start to release the stuff that you really want.
But you knew it was coming. So
if you could hold back.
I mean, I'm not disagreeing that it's a dirty trick, but you know, they didn't say no Super Articulated figures are coming and all of a sudden hit you all of a sudden after, you know, figures have shipped. You knew it was coming, so if you wanted to wait for it, you know, you could wait for it. And they're great-looking figures, and for the same price of the Armor Up figures, you can get a Super Articulated figure, better accessories.
I know.
I haven't pulled the trigger. I've bought very few of the 5POA figures. but I haven't pulled the trigger on any of the super articulated ones, and I've seen them all in stores, and they look great, but it's so horrible to say this, but for $13 for a super articulated 3¾-inch figure, I can wait till the end of the Christmas season and probably get a 6-inch figure for the same price.
Well, he's got a point there, people.
And it's just, this is past history. I'm not saying anything that hasn't already happened. Look at the past 2 years on the Amazon history of some of these products that have gone down. There'll be a fire sale, and you'll get a $11.99 6-inch Stormtrooper. You'll get a $12.99, you know.
No, it's true. Whoever. It's definitely true. So, I mean, we're gonna start seeing Phasma in much larger quantities, sort of hanging around the pegs. You know, I've even already started seeing the Target 2-packs pretty regularly. You know, I mean, I'm not seeing, and the same thing with the Toys R Us Snowtroopers. I'm seeing them pretty regularly. So it seems to me that, you know, they're in the beginning with these exclusives and things that, you know, that seem to be kind of hyped. They, you know, it seems like there's larger quantities sort of floating around, and eventually they're just going to start kind of, you know, cutting the price on them and liquidating them. And so if you're willing to wait, it's like, it's the old thing. It's like if you're a seasoned collector like us, you know that what's coming. It's like the same rule book every time. You know, it's like nothing changes. It's like when I see what Topps does. You know, it's like the same thing. Topps is going to be Topps. You know, they're going to do the same thing every time. And so with collecting, same thing every time. But part of us can't say no to that first feverish pitch, you know, where we got to get our hands on something. You're like, we just can't contain ourselves. We don't have any patience. It's a bad vice to have no patience in this thing.
And this, people, is what's called marketing. Remilking and sending this stuff out there for customers. But love to know everyone else's thoughts on what you think on LEGO, the availabilities we've talked about, and getting these minifigures and FLEGO and all that kind of stuff. Please leave a comment. Let us know what you think, either on Twitter or on YouTube where this video is, and let us know. Anything else you guys have got you want to plug, talk about, or we'll wrap things up, I think. We're all good.
Seems like we're good.
I don't think we'll probably have another show now until the new year, because, again, there's really not a lot of LEGO news probably going to hit until the beginning of January. And it is already the 3rd of December at the time of doing this show.
Yeah. So. Well, we'll probably start seeing some of those. I'm already seeing some of those 2016 sets at my Toys R Us, but none of the licensed sets. Only the City and the Technic. Those are already out and pretty plentiful. Most Toys R Us are putting them out way early. Yep. But like Marvel and Star Wars, you'll probably see at the end of December. You'll see them a little early.
If we get an abundance of news, maybe we'll be back for the end of the year. But I think probably in the new year we'll be back with some juicy images and information on LEGO sets. Definitely the place to find out some LEGO news is from these two guys here, and myself as well, on Twitter. You can follow Matt Studshooter at Studshooter with a brand new shiny studs logo. Follow him there and on your blog, which is studshooter.com.
Studshooter.com.
Studshooter. So. How can you forget that, people?
Just search Studshooter and you'll find me. So.
Stud on the internet. And also, a good friend is there with LEGO News and other good stuff. He seems to be the sense of the year for all toys. So follow him for all sorts of news and stuff is Scott there as well. So Scott from Tulsa on Twitter, I think, is the best place for you, yes?
It is. It is the only place to find me. So I hide everywhere else, but I am on Twitter regularly. So
And follow him because he's a bargain hunter.
Yes.
So if you're looking for bargains, he's got them.
If I can find something cheap, I'll let you know. I try to, you know, it's usually, if I find it, I'll snap it, and it's usually, I'm the one standing in the middle of the aisle that you're trying to get your cart around while I'm trying to put something on the internet. So.
So yes, follow these guys on Twitter for some news and info. You can find me on Twitter as well under @FlyGuy. We've got a little dedicated playlist for all the last previous shows if you want to catch up and have a look back on some stuff. And again, all the show notes are under the video. All the links are there. So thank you for everybody else who's watched and joined and tweeted and all of us online. Thank you very much for that. And we'll see you for another Complete Bricks podcast coming up soon. That's it for me. You can say goodbye, guys.
Oh, bye. Good night. Happy holidays.
Okay, you're just going to cut it. Just cut.